You see this, this, and this? I bet you didn't notice that some of the search results on Google have this snippet. And do you know, you can take advantage of this snippet and grow your search traffic? The best part is, it is easy to optimize for this snippet and you don't need to understand technical coding and you don't need to put in much work. You are already doing a lot of work on your article anyway, so why not just spend a couple more minutes optimizing your article by adding questions and answers that you probably already have on your page to get a snippet like this. This snippet is called the FAQ Rich Snippet, by the way, so if you want to claim this snippet for your article, let's get cracking. What's up everyone, it's Jack here from RankMath, the WordPress SEO plugin that gives your content the best chance of beating your competitors on search engines. Now let's get right to the basics first. What is FAQ schema markup and what are the benefits? Why should you even bother about this? You know what FAQ is, right? It's frequently asked questions, and as for schema markup, or in other words, structured data, it is a way for your webpage to communicate with search engines, telling them what's going on your page. So an FAQ schema markup is basically telling search engines that your page has an FAQ section. It is as simple as that. Now, having this markup not only allows your article to occupy more spaces in the search engine results page, but your article is also delivering more content to the searcher even before they click through to your page. Hence, it increases the likelihood of them actually clicking through to your article. It decreases bounce rates, it implies to the searcher that your article has the answer for them. As a result, they will stay longer on your page and hence it sends a positive signal to search engines leading to higher rankings. Plus, your page will also be eligible for voice search action done by Google Assistant. As you know, voice search is getting more popular by the day, so optimizing your page for it just makes total sense. Now, I just want to clarify something before we move forward. Having this FAQ rich snippet doesn't guarantee a top spot for you on Google. Google will rank your website based on the content that is deemed most helpful to its users. And sometimes, Google may not even show the FAQ markups in certain queries. But since you are already spending so much time writing your article and adding FAQ schema is not that time consuming, why not just optimize for the snippet, which may lead to all the benefits I've just mentioned. Anyway, let's get into the actual work on your website and do stick with me to the end because I will share with you some best practices and the do's and the don'ts about the FAQ schema. Critical stuff for you to understand, so stay tuned. Now let me walk you through a real life example because that way you'll know exactly how to implement this FAQ schema to your articles. So on this keyword, best bamboo toilet papers, we have this article here. No FAQ schema has been added to this page yet. Depending on the topic your article is about, the FAQs may be different and in some cases there is no point in adding an FAQ schema. We'll talk more about that later. Now let's talk about step one, which is to find FAQ questions to answer in your article. Google has made it super easy for us to find FAQ topics related to the keyword, which is this people also asked section. You've got to understand the intention behind the keyword you are targeting. In this case, people who are searching for best bamboo toilet papers have the intention to buy, but they will have pre-sale questions like, will bamboo toilet papers clog toilets? Are bamboo toilet papers eco-friendly? And many others. If you have trouble imagining what people will think, just expand whatever makes sense in this people also ask section, and you will see more and more related questions popping up at the bottom. This is probably the best way to find FAQ questions to be added to your article. Alternatively, you can go to Quora and search for the same keyword. Sometimes the results shown here are not relevant, so you gotta refine your search. Such as in this case, we remove the best, and we will have something like, are bamboo toilet paper sustainable, which is more sustainable and eco-friendly, bamboo toilet paper, or 100% recycled toilet paper. You can also add question modifiers such as how, when, why, where, who, which, etc. to find some FAQs that make sense to be added to your article. Another simpler method to find FAQ questions is to use RankMath's Content AI. Now, assuming you're writing an article on the WordPress blog editor, you want to click on the RankMath's tab. And over here, you'll see Content AI. Click on that. You want to put in the focus keyword. And you want to select a location. For this case, I will use worldwide. And let's click on research.
Now give it a while, and over here under questions, it will give you some cool suggestions on what FAQs to add to your page. We think these are the three best ways to find FAQ questions.
We don't want to share more than that because it might be counterproductive for you. But if you want more methods to find FAQ questions, feel free to visit the link to our article in the description. We have a very detailed tutorial on FAQ schema. So once you have found the FAQ questions, the next step is to go to your article and optimize it.
Now, we at RankMath have made it super easy for us to add schema markups without learning a single line of code. So the first thing we need to do is to go to your installed plugins tab and make sure that the RankMath plugin is installed. If it is not installed, click on add new and on the search bar, type in RankMath and you will see this here.
Now, in case you're using other SEO plugins and you decide to follow this tutorial, we highly recommend that you visit the articles in the description first to import your site data over to RankMath before continuing with this tutorial. This is to avoid losing existing data on your site, and we really don't want that to happen to you. But if you're already a RankMath user, let's get to it.
Now on the blog editor, you need to choose a section where you want to add the FAQ schema. It will usually be at the bottom of the page, but it really depends on the search intent of the keyword. For this example, the topic is best bamboo toilet papers. So people are looking to buy the best product. And as content creators, we need to first satisfy the search intent by listing down all the possible products before adding, for example, a buyer's guide, followed by the FAQ section. Now this FAQ section is pre-written, so let's convert this into the FAQ schema markup. As you hover to the question, let's add a block, browse all, and on the left hand side, as you scroll down, you will see the blocks provided by RankMath. You want to select this FAQ by RankMath. This is the first question. Let's copy this and let's paste it here. Let's copy the answers as well and let's paste it here. And now we can remove this completely. Let's do the same for answer as well. Next, we want to add a new FAQ. Copy the second question and paste it here. We'll do the same for the answer and we're done with this. Let's remove this block after you have pasted them over to the FAQ schema and we'll add a new FAQ. So let me fast forward this process so we won't waste your time watching me copy and paste. And we are done. Now as you can see, RankMath has made it really easy for us to hide questions and remove them if we want to. And if you're on the RankMath Pro version, you can easily sort the questions by moving them up and down. This is a very handy function and I'll explain to you why in a while. You can even add an image here to prove a point if you wish. Now let me show you how the FAQ schema looks on the live page. As you can see, whatever that you have added to the FAQ schema will be present on the page. It flows normally just as how a typical article flows. You can even make this section look a little different than the rest of the article, but you need to know a little bit of CSS to do so. If you go back to the blog editor, make sure that you have selected the FAQ schema, and then make sure that you have chosen this gear icon, toggle this to blog, and you will see a few options here. You can turn the list out of your FAQ to a numbered list or bulleted points. You can change the title tag to whichever you need, but we recommend H3. You can select the size of the image. And if you want to make the FAQ section a little different from the rest of the page, you can add CSS classes here. Now, the next thing you want to do is to sort the FAQs by importance because Google will only display two FAQs on your search results page. So we have to be smart in thinking which are the two FAQs that will help with the search intent. For this case, people looking to buy bamboo toilet paper will want to know if it will clog their toilet. It is highly relevant and you are answering a question that they probably have not thought about. Imagine them scrolling through the search result and they see this question on your article, whereas the top competitors do not have this snippet. Will the searcher engage with your FAQ? I think it is most likely. So I will bring this question up to the top. And then the next question that I will bring to the top is probably going to be, are bamboo toilet papers biodegradable? I think this question is more important than, for example, recycled toilet paper versus bamboo toilet paper. Because when somebody is searching for best bamboo toilet paper, it probably means that they have already done the research and they have decided that bamboo toilet paper is what they want to buy. So I think this question helps the searcher intend more. So I will bring this to the top as well. I hope you understand how to choose the FAQs to be listed first. Now, the next thing we want to do is to improve on the answer because Google will not display everything here. They will display a short paragraph, so we need to be as concise as possible. We recommend keeping it within 200 characters, but sometimes Google do display more characters, but you get the idea. Just be as concise as possible with your answers. In this case, the current answer is this. The first sentence is good, but we have a lot more info we want to add. So let's convert this sentence into something like this. And it replaces this chunk of text here. This is a punchy sentence because it is rich with answers and within 160 to 200 characters. That's how you should be answering your questions. Now let's do one more since Google only displays two. You see, the first sentence does not answer the question directly, so we have to change this. So we basically cut down two paragraphs into one. I hope you see what I mean. But if your answer needs a lot more explanation, it's best that you give a very good gist of your answer right at the top in the first paragraph. That's how you should structure your answers. Now you can optimize the rest of the answers if you want to, but for this tutorial, we will skip to the next step. Now let's take the guesswork out of the process by validating if the FAQ schema is valid on your page. We will go to Google's Rich Result Testing tool. We have left a link in the description as well for your convenience. And what we recommend that you do is to copy the source code of your page and paste it here. So we'll go to your page and right click, View Page Source. And you want to hit Ctrl A or Command A if you're on Mac to select everything. And you want to hit Ctrl C or Command C to copy everything. And let's go back to the Rich Result Testing tool and paste the code here. And then you want to select test code. And it appears that we have the FAQ schema here. If we expand it out, click on this detected items, we have all the questions and answers in this schema. Now that we know the FAQ schema is present and valid on our page, it's time for us to tell Google, hey, we have something new on our site. Come and check it out and update your search engine. I'm pretty sure you know what Google Search Console is. It is the place for us webmasters to communicate with Google. All you need to do is place the URL of the page containing the FAQ schema and hit enter. And then you need to give it a while. And then you want to click on Request Indexing. In this step, you're basically asking the Google robots to check out your updated page. And once done, under the Performance tab and under Search Appearance, after some time has passed, you will have an FAQ snippet here where you can monitor the clicks and impressions. And as you have seen it, it is not a difficult task, so why not just do it? Other use cases we think the FAQ schema will be helpful are the single product pages where you need to include an FAQ section, software documentation where you are creating tutorials about your software and you have an FAQ section, support and customer service pages where an FAQ section is needed, a sales landing page where FAQ is present, and basically any pages where you think an FAQ section makes sense. Now, in case you are not able to use the FAQ block from the blog editor, for example, at this moment, WooCommerce is still using the classic editor, what you will need is a schema generator that is included in the RankMath Pro. We will show you an example of it when we are talking about the best practices. Now let's talk about the do's and don'ts and the best practices of FAQ snippets. Let's start with the don'ts. Number one, if your page allows users to submit multiple answers to a single question, like a forum or something like Quora or Reddit, don't use the FAQ schema. Use the Q&A page schema instead. There is a link in the description, we have a tutorial on that. Number two, do not abuse the FAQ snippet for promotional and advertising purposes. This is a Google guideline, do not test the system and risk your website. Number three, whatever you have added into the FAQ schema needs to be present on the page. Do not hide or truncate any parts of the answers or have different versions of an answer. However, if you are using, for example, Elementor or the classic WordPress editor, it is not that straightforward. In Elementor, there is no FAQ block for you to add to the content, so you have to rely on our schema generator that is in the pro version of RankMath. That is unless you want to use the accordion element where you can add the FAQ schema here. RankMath is very well integrated with Elementor, but to generalize this, if you are not using the accordion element and you want to add an FAQ schema, you want to use the schema generator. To use that, click on SEO, and over here, click on Schema, and you will see the Schema Generator here. Click on that, and as you scroll down, you will see the FAQ schema here, and you want to add property, and from here, you'll be able to add your questions and answers as per normal. However, as you save this, note that whatever text you have added to the schema remains in the background of the page as a code. So you have to make sure that all the text you have entered in the schema is visible on the page. Another method in Elementor, if you do not want to manually type in the questions and answers, is to use a short code that can be found in the schema generator. Right here, you want to copy this, add an element, search for shortcode, and you want to paste the shortcode here, and the text will appear. This will work as well. Now, when it comes to the classic editor, the same is true as you cannot add an FAQ block to the editor. You will have to use the schema generator, which can be found at the bottom of the text area, under schema. Click on schema generator, and you will see the FAQ here. Click on add property and you'll be able to add your questions and answers here. And you gotta ensure that whatever text that you have entered in the schema needs to be present on the page. I hope this is clear because it is an important guideline if you want to leverage on the FAQ schema. Number 4, if either of your FAQ questions and answers contains anything that may be construed as sexually explicit, graphically violent, dangerous, illegal content, and anything in the likes of it, don't use the FAQ schema. Number 5, do not add FAQ schema markup on repeated questions and answers. For example, you have multiple articles that have similar or repeated questions and answers. Do not add FAQ schema on all articles. Just mark one of them. That's it for the don'ts. It's pretty straightforward, right? Now let's talk about the best practices. Do you know you can use the FAQ schema as a way to do internal linking? Let me share with you why this is a good practice. Basically, with FAQ, if the answer satisfies the question, the searcher may not have any reasons to click through to your website to read further. That's the adverse effect of an FAQ. But if you have placed a link in your answer that expands out to a relevant topic, it might result in a click. And generally, internal linking between relevant pieces of articles on your website is a good SEO practice that gives your site more SEO juice. But you have to make sure that the links you place on your answers are relevant. Do not place random links here. The content behind the links need to be helpful to the searcher. In this example, we have an article that explains how bamboo is biodegradable. It is highly relevant if somebody wants to do further research after seeing your answer in the FAQ schema. So I will put a link to the text biodegradable in nature. The next best practice is to keep your answers between 160 to 200 characters, at least for the first sentence where you give all the context. Because in most instances, Google will not show more than 200 characters. You really have to be clear and concise as possible, as I've shown you in the earlier example. That's basically it. If you want to know more about the Google guidelines on FAQ schema, you can find the link in the description. We have covered everything that we know about the FAQ schema. If you still have any questions, feel free to leave a comment down below and our team will help you out as much as we can. Anyway, if this video has provided value to you, please do us a little favor and smash that thumbs up button. It will really help our Rank Math channel grow and we will continue to provide you with tons of value to help you beat your competitors on search engines. So don't forget to subscribe and hit the bell notification to get more knowledge and insights delivered straight to your YouTube notification. This is Jack from Rank Math, and I'll see you in the next video.